All right, nice. That was unexpected. Welcome to another episode in the deep playthrough of Gran Turismo 7. I really was struggling getting through that 38.2 time. And now I'm suddenly doing a 37.5. That's pretty damn weird. Really took me like 20, 30 tries. In between episodes, I started at the end of the previous episodes, but was failing all the time, so I thought, alright, I will just discard all my failed attempts and have the successful attempt at the start of this episode. Suddenly, I don't know where I got that time suddenly, but it worked for sure. Let's go to the next sector. There are only two sectors. So the next one is right, left, right corner, basically. And what I really noticed in this car is you can get on the power quite early. It's a four-wheel drive car, old tech four-wheel drive, but it works like a charm, it seems. You really can, as soon as your car is more or less positioned in the right direction, just slam the accelerator. You will not, there's quite some grip, so you will not as easily spin out as in other cars. And also, of course, the power, it's not that much. Only 209 horsepower I see now. I thought this car would maybe have a bit more than that, but... anyways, I am happy with this first sector. More than happy, actually. No idea where I got, like, more than a second from. I was more than a second quicker, I guess. Right? Or wasn't I? Yes, I was 27.3, I guess. Hello, game. What the hell are you doing? Why do we go all the way out of everything? 37.3. And the gold time? No. It's a little bit less than a second. Almost a second. This one. Right, but it really is taking quite a lot of trial and error to get this all right. As you see, the brakes are really bad. And the time is quite tight, so not even that bad. I only need 2/10 more. Wow, I really screwed up a couple of corners. And again, just like really should brake earlier for this one. But yeah, you also really don't have that much aids helping you out. I was off track, but I don't care. If it's a gold, it's a gold. Alright, and for now the full track, which I hope the time is not that sharp, because quite a tricky track, but it's very short. Here we go. Weird starting points, by the way. During the sector times, there was no problem hitting those signs. God damn it! Right, quite an annoying track, to be honest. So this starting position, it's... cannot hit that sign apparently. Well, I hit it several times during the sector test. Missing the apex over there. No way! First attempt. Right, that's a super lenient goal time. Because I really was not that well, so or that it was not that great of a lap. I will quickly show you how I approached it. Alright, so this is a slightly lift off. I'm not even sure it's necessary, but I slightly lifted off. And over here, more or less full throttle. And over here, this very long corner, I do think it's an important corner because you carry quite some speed up the through the whole corner. I'm not even sure how what the best way is, but apparently, or what I think do have to do consistently is lift off a little bit over here. Otherwise, you will go wide over here. You will go too quickly. So lift off a bit, but then once you get to the outside over here, already. Yeah, play around with the throttle, try to keep as much speed. So it's not only lifting off, it's also accelerating a bit. And then also here, try to cut that corner. Don't go with four corners into wheels into the sand, then you will be disqualified. But like two wheels into the dirt doesn't matter here. Play around with the accelerator and lifting off to keep the car on the tarmac, and then try to make as you much use as possible of the width of the track to accelerate as fast as possible out of here, but while avoiding that 150 meter sign, because that seems to be an instant disqualification. Full throttle, and after the 50 meter marker, brake hard back to what I think is second. Try to over here, the corner seems to tighten up after the apex, so immediately turn as much as possible in, and already over here, even while you have still quite some steering input and you're not even positioned correctly yet, you can, I think, almost already apply full throttle because of the four-wheel drive and the grip that it provides. You won't really spin out. Here, hug a little bit the left side to keep the distance shorter than going through the outside of the corner. And over here, just after the 50 meter marker, again, start braking hard, back to second, and then already start steering in. And here back, I think it's first, back to first, steer in quite a lot to quickly rotate the car, and then again, just like that other corner on top of the hill, that kind of hairpin, you can already start applying full throttle at this moment already to carry as much, even if it's a slow corner, but carry as much exit speed as possible. And over here, this section, I did the sector test, like, I don't know, a couple of times, but yeah, it's really just trial and error for me. It just somehow worked. I do think the time must be very lenient because I really didn't go through here that well. It's the hard thing is that there is not really a lot of visual cues on where the best breakpoint is. So it's mostly on feel a little bit. So just get brake, get the speed out, try to cut the corner a little bit, try to turn as quickly as possible, and then already from here, just like the other hairpins, apply full throttle already. This one I took, I braked too late because I only start turning in over here. I could have been like a whole car width more to the apex, so to say, to shorten the distance of travel. Anyways, it was apparently still good enough. Turn in as much as possible, and again, accelerate out as soon as possible. Same one for this one. Just brake, turn in as sharp as possible, and accelerate out as soon as possible. Then over here, to be honest, I don't even recognize it that well. That is how briefly I've been at this second sector test, and it doesn't really stick to mind, but I do think I lifted off a little bit over here to keep the car a little bit on track, and then over here just full throttle through that little kink, and that was enough. Alright, we'll do pretty cool, these back seats and stuff, quite detailed. What the hell? No, oh fuck, now I screwed up my god damn it, now I screwed up my replay. Oh, I'm such an idiot, man. So that's a bummer. I wanted to show the outside replay as well. I always liked that in Gran Turismo, but I accidentally started the race, and that if you didn't save the replay, it clears the previous replay, it seems. Anyhow, that is another circuit experience in the pocket. And a bit of extra cash in the bank. Right, so what's on the agenda? Still some minutes in the episode. I do think all the tracks that have now been unlocked. I did all the circuit experiences. I'm just looking at them to make sure. Yes, pretty sure I did all of these. These one as well. And man, I still have post-traumatic stress disorder of the Tokyo Expressway East course. And I think also the central one. God damn it, those were hard for me. High speed ring. Which car was that again? Don't even remember. It was the Zonda. It was a long time ago. Yes, but I think all the circuit experiences with all the tracks available now are done. So we will be continuing our menu book. Collection Mustang. Tracks unlocked Daytona International Speedway USA. So we have to get a Mustang 69, 71 and 2015. And for this menu you'll be collecting Mustangs. The Mustang series of high performance cars was produced by Ford and is widely considered an American classic. Collect all three models and bring them back here, then I'll tell you all about these legendary cars. Yeah, but right, how to get the car? Boss Ford 2969. Blue Moon Speedway by competing in the above road circuits race. Recommended car, Ford Mustang GT50. Mustang GT 50. Alright, let's see. Oh, did I start the menu book now? No, I don't think I did. Also, I have to press start. Alright, we have some races to do over here, but start with two Windows cars. You can also buy them, but doing the races is nicer. Gift car, third place or higher. Front rear challenge, 550. Alright, what's the PP? That suggests PP is 550. Alright, this race will pit you against some ferociously fast 550 performance points class American front rear sport cars. Main rivals, Firebird Trans Am, also a very cool car. Super B, Firebird Trans Am, Mustang Mach 1. But those cars, they don't have that much. PP, I would say, as like the suggested car, which was a 2015. But I don't want to, again, just like in Alsace a couple of episodes ago, I spent like a whole week trying to win the race because I don't want to tune cars in these races, but I really started with a way underpowered car, and then it can almost be impossible to win. But so I could go with one of these older ones, but I'm pretty sure that there will then also be one of the newer Mustangs and that will be near impossible to win. So maybe I will just go with the suggested car, that was that Mustang 2015. Not sure if I have that one in my garage. No. Here you see the suggested, this is only a 447 PP car. Well, the race is recommended at 550. That's quite a big difference. Let's check out that, whether I can buy that Mustang. Probably I need to go to Grand Central, I'm not sure. Don't see a lot of Mustangs over here. This one seems to be way too cheap. I thought that Sotheby's or was some kind of an Brooklands or some kind of an auction house assisted Polyphony Digital in determining realistic car prices, but this car should not be the same price as a regular 458 Italian. It's crazy. That car exploded in value, that C8, I'm pretty sure. We also have some roulette to unlock. All right, nice. Pretty cool car. 723, that's quite a lot. PP. Alright, 5-star tickets. yes, I don't mind this Corvette at all. I really like this combination. Like the this is of course a Group 3. I don't really like that. I prefer just a road car, but a yellow Corvette, really nice. I guess I can also use this car in this race, but let's just go with the suggested car. So let's just follow how the designers intended a little bit. So we go to Brand Central, America, Ford. Mustang, 2015 they said, right? What, how much is this? Performance points, where are they? Oh man, ah, there, 574, yeah, that's a bit much. I don't think there is a Mustang 2050. God damn it, why is everything so tiresome? Ah, here it is. I'm just an idiot. So this is 539. Yes, sounds about right. Yeah, I like white. It's perfectly fine. I also like this silver actually. Let's just go with white. A bit of a Ford racing color, I guess. The GT Le Mans cars, the GT40s, they were white, right? With blue stripes. Maybe I'm just totally mixing it up. Oh shit, this is one of the cars that we needed. That's not what I wanted. I want to earn the cars. God damn it, so annoying. Oh my fucking hell, it's so annoying. I want to play the game, get the content out of it. But then why do they say recommended car here, a Mustang GT15? So people will start to buy it. It's the first race. But then you immediately have it from, you screw up your third race. Because that's the car that you need from that one. So I really hate this weird Japanese game design. Just recommend any other car than the one that you win in one of these races. So that you can do all the races. Crazy. Sorry, that was a little bit of an anticlimactic. That car is recommended for all these three races, which is also a bit weird. So yeah, in the next menu book I really try to pay better attention to that. Maybe I will just buy some lower PP car and then yeah, tune it up a little bit to the recommended level. Anyways, guys, there's no more time in the episode to do this race now. I will do it at the start of the next episode. You will immediately see the successful attempt. So if there's any failed attempts, I will just discard them because, yeah, it's the start of new episodes. So I can just keep in the playthrough whatever I choose. So the successful run. Hope you still enjoyed. Hope to see you in the next episode. And for the meantime, do not forget, always do keep on gaming, Slipter.